Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Easy Online English. I'm Sahara, and I want to know if you've ever been in a weather event in the United States. Sometimes, depending on the state where you are, it can get kind of scary, especially if you don't understand what the weather reporters are talking about. They can speak very quickly. So in this video, we are looking at three different weather reports. And be sure to watch all the way to the end because I will be giving you some tips on how to understand severe weather and how to follow it in English because I lived in a state that had severe weather. Okay, let's go.
If you want to know the translation in your language, be sure to check the translated subtitles here.
So first we're going to be talking about storm systems and how we talk about them in English. Also, for each report, we'll be showing you the clip first, and then we'll be discussing how the language is used. Okay, let's look at the first report.
Our main storm system did depart overnight while you were asleep, but in the process, dumped a whole lot of snow.
Okay, so she spoke very quickly, but this is what she said. She said, our main storm system did depart overnight while you were asleep, but in the process, dumped a whole lot of snow. So first, let's talk about storm system. Storm system simply is just a collection of storms. And she is saying that this whole storm system has left the area. It departed overnight. And not only does she say that it snowed a lot, she uses the word dumped. And if you think about a dump truck or a garbage truck, how it can tip everything over and dump all of the contents out of the truck, this is the image that she's using to describe the snowfall from the storm system. So it left the area, it departed overnight, and it dumped a whole lot of snow when it did.
Our main storm system did depart overnight while you were asleep, but in the process, dumped a whole lot of snow.
Okay, so let's look at the next one. The next one, specifically look at the word throughout. See if you can hear them say it.
We do still have winter storm warnings in place throughout the region.
Okay, so again, they spoke very quickly, so let's read what they said. We do still have winter storm warnings in place throughout the region. So because of these storm systems, there are official warnings for the public throughout the area. So this just means everywhere. We would say throughout instead of all over the area. You could say that, but you could also say throughout more commonly. Also, the other ways to describe a storm system could be moving through an area or maybe hovering or lingering if it's not moving very quickly. Or if it's starting to dissipate, you would say that it's breaking up. So the collections of storms or the storm system is breaking up.
We do still have winter storm warnings in place throughout the region.
All right, next let's move on and look at some 7-day forecast weather. In these clips, we'll be looking at weather reports from Arizona. And specifically, the first one is about temperatures and wind chill factors. So let's look at it.
Let's check those temperatures right now. It's 1 below in Kansas City and Oklahoma City. They've warmed to 9 in Dallas, 4 below in Minneapolis and 13 in Chicago, 17 right now in Detroit. And wind chill making it feel even colder with temperatures below 0.
Okay, she spoke very quickly, right? she was actually listing all of the temperatures across the United States in multiple cities. So this is what she said. It's 1 below in Kansas City and Oklahoma City. They have warmed up to 9 in Dallas, 4 below in Minneapolis, and 13 in Chicago, 17 right now in Detroit. Wind chill is making it feel even colder with the temperatures below zero. So what she's saying here is that the wind chill is affecting the temperatures. So normally the temperature is this, but the wind chill is the actual temperature that is outside, including the wind. So that's why she's including it with the temperatures that she's listing. So the wind is making it feel even colder than it actually is.
Let's check those temperatures right now. It's 1 below in Kansas City and Oklahoma City. They've warmed to 9 in Dallas, 4 below in Minneapolis, and 13 in Chicago, 17 right now in Detroit. And wind chill making it feel even colder with temperatures below zero.
All right, let's look at another clip from the same report. She's going to talk about the wind forecast for the state of Arizona. All right, let's look at it.
By later this afternoon, we'll see some 10 to 20 mile per hour winds across the state that could gust up to 30 miles per hour. We'll be windy again tomorrow. The winds finally ease up and we start to warm up by the end of the week and into the weekend.
Let's review what she said. She says, by later this afternoon, we'll see some 10 to 20 mile per hour winds across the state that could gust up to 30 miles per hour. The winds start to ease up and will start to warm up by the end of the week and into the weekend. So the reporter is using the word gust and two different phrasal verbs in this sentence. Did you catch that? So what she's saying is that the winds could gust up to 30 miles per hour. And a gust is just a strong, violently blowing wind. So typically the wind that day would be 10 to 20 miles per hour, or you might feel a giant gust going up to 30 miles per hour. She's also saying that the wind will ease up. This means that the wind will start to slow down.
By later this afternoon, we'll see some 10 to 20 mile per hour winds across the state that could gust up to 30 miles per hour. We'll be windy again tomorrow. The winds finally ease up and we start to warm up by the end of the week and into the weekend.
Now, remember in the beginning of the video where I told you that I would give you some tips about listening to severe weather reports? So that's this part of that video right now. And it's really important if you live in the United States to know what kind of severe weather is in your area. If you're visiting or living in these areas, it's really important to memorize your location because when you watch the report, the reporter will describe the areas to you and they most likely will do it very quickly. So you need to already know the names and in areas that they're going to be using in the report. So typically the things that you would need to know if you're living in a severe weather area is your county. So you have a state, but you also have little states inside the states. These are called counties. So you need to know the name of your county that you're living in. You need to know your city, of course. You also need to know the nearest major roads to you. So maybe you live in a smaller neighborhood or maybe a side street. Definitely know the nearest major road, intersection, or highway that's close to you. And then of course, the nearest major landmarks that are near you. So if you hear them say a specific landmark, you know, oh, I live near there. I should be in a safe place. So I'll give you an example from my home state. So this used to be my location. It's not anymore, but it used to be. So I lived in the state of Alabama. I lived in Jefferson County. Then I lived in a city called Hoover. A major highway that was near me is Highway 31. And then a major landmark that was near me is the Galleria Shopping Mall. So I knew if I ever listened to a weather report that if they started talking about these areas a lot, I would know, ooh, maybe I need to be more aware of what's happening. Okay, let's look at the next clips. And the word that I want you to focus in on is polygons. Polygons. This is an important one. Okay, let's watch it.
Nonetheless, still play it safe if you're in that polygon.
Okay, did you hear polygons? This is what they said. Nonetheless, still play it safe if you're in that polygon. Nonetheless, still play it safe if you're in that polygon. So the weather radar and software that they use, it generates special shapes on the map. And these shapes are called polygons. They're just random shapes. But the weather reporters use these when there is severe weather because it gives them an estimate of where the action will be. So they usually will refer to the polygons all of the time if there's a major severe weather event happening. So if you are inside of the polygon, you are at risk of severe weather. So she is using the expression play it safe here. And this means to just be cautious, right? If you're located inside, like I said, or near this polygon or in the path of the polygon, you just need to be careful and you need to be in a safe location.
Nonetheless, still play it safe if you're in that polygon.
All right, the last clip is from the same report. And I want you to hear the word warning. See if you can hear them talk about that.
Oh, Steve just told me they just canceled the tornado warning. No more tornado warning issued.
All right, so this is what they said. Oh, Steve just told me they canceled the tornado warning. So no more tornado warning issued. A warning is an official statement from the National Weather Service, and this is an organization that monitors weather all across the nation. So if a warning is issued for your county, this means that there are certain severe storms or weather events happening in your area. And here she says the warning was canceled by the National Weather Service. Warnings can also expire. But usually the National Weather Service will give a time limit for the warning. So for example, what you typically hear from a weather reporter is something like this. The National Weather Service has issued a tornado warning for Jefferson County until 7:40 p.m. this evening. So you can hear that usually on the radio. Sometimes you'll get an alert on your phone. A warning just means that there are severe things happening and you need to watch the weather or be in a safe place.
Oh, Steve just told me they just canceled the tornado warning. No more tornado warning issued.
Thank you guys so much for watching another video here with us on Easy Online English. As for my weather today, it is sunny. Why don't you comment down below and let us know what is the weather like in your area? Also, we do have some other weather videos, so if you want to learn some more about how to talk about weather, click right here. And we will see you soon in the next video. Goodbye.